Hello everyone, I'm Shine and you are watching Civil Engineering Tips channel. This is second tutorial of STAAD.Pro. To analyze and design a structure, you have to draw it first. Without drawing, we cannot do anything with our structure. So first step is drawing it. Basically, we draw nodes and beams in STAAD.Pro. All kind of beams and columns are considered as beam in STAAD.Pro. First, we specify the endpoints of a beam, which are called nodes, and then we join them and finally we get the beam. In the screen you can see three types of beams. First one is cantilever simply supported beam, second one is continuous beam, and third one is simple 2D frame. Today we are going to draw these three kinds of beams. Later in other videos we will fit supports and apply loads. In this video first we will draw them. There are three methods of drawing node, which is point, and beam, which is line. First one is snap node or beam method, second one is coordinate method, and third one is run structure wizard method. We will discuss the first one in this tutorial. This is the easiest method of drawing nodes and beams. Under snap node or beam method, there are three type of grids: linear grids, radial grids, and irregular grids. Every time you open your STAAD.Pro software, you will get these grids in your workspace. Somehow, if you are not seeing these grids, like if I cross this window, then the grids will vanish. If you want back your grids, then go to the geometry option. If you click here, the grids will appear again in your workspace and you will get this window again. Not only geometry option, you can disable or enable these grids from here also. There is an icon. If you click here, the grids will vanish, and if you click again, the grids will appear. Or you can go to geometry option from menu bar. If you click here, there will be a option snap or grid node, and here you will get that icon again. If you click here, the grids will vanish. The first step of drawing a structure, you have to use geometry. So I'm clicking here and I'm getting this grid on my workspace again. So you have a graph in front of you and you have points to map. As it is from isometric view, it is little bit twisted. If you want to make it straight, then you have to view it from Z direction. Then you will get the graph on XY plane and it will not be twisted anymore. So I'm going here and click on this icon, view from Z axis. Then our graph is straight now. Again, if we click on isometric view option, then the graph will be twisted. So this is our graph or grid, whatever you say, and we will draw on it. To edit this grid, you have to come to this window and you will get some options. This is our default grid. Every time you click on geometry option, you will get this default grid. So now come to the axis or these points. Now it is on XY plane and we are getting our coordinates on X axis and Y axis. If you want to show the direction of your axis, you can click in this box. If you click on this box, there will be a plus sign because this is positive X axis and this is positive Y axis. If you want to make it more clear, then come here and check this box and you will get the axis also. This is X axis and this is Y axis. You can change the font of your numbers also from this font option. Anyway, I'm happy with this font, no problem, and I don't want to make it complicated, so I'm unchecking these two box and now I am getting a simple grid. If you want to make it more simple, then come here and you will get the frequency. Now the frequency is 1. The difference between two numbers is 1. If you don't want a lot of numbers, then you can increase your frequency. Like if I make it 2, then the numbers have been decreased, but there is a point that is 1 point, it is 2, it is 3, it is 4. But to simplify it, we are just hiding it. If we make it 5, then I will get only 2 points visible, that is 5 and 10. Similarly, you can change your frequency in Y direction also. I'm making it 5. So now it is simple and you can use this grid so easily. Anyway, I'm coming back to the frequency. I'm making it 1, and for Y direction also it is 1. If you want exact coordinates, like not only X coordinates, also Y coordinates, here Y coordinate is 0, here also it is 0, then you can choose the Y option. You click here and you are getting both coordinates. Similarly, if you want the both coordinates in Y direction, then come here, Y direction direction and click on X, then you will get both coordinates in both direction. I don't need to be more complicated like this. I am just clicking on Y and X, then I'm making it simple. So you can use this default grid if you want. You can edit or modify also from here. There is a lot of options and you can make it as your own, but I don't want to use this default grid, so I'm clicking OK. And come here, there is a option, create option. I'm clicking here and the same window comes for your own grid. First of all, you have to give a name of your grid. There is a option, name option. I'm giving it a name, my grid. You can choose any plane for your grid and you can change the angle of your grid from here. It will be twisted according to the axis you choose. Now it is Y axis. If I give some angle here, it will be twisted according to Y axis. Anyway, I'm happy with this zero angle, so just keep it as it is. You can choose any point as origin of your grid. Now it is 0 0 0. I'm keeping it as it is. Now come to these options. Our X coordinates starts from 0. If you are not happy with this, then you can change it. Like if you want to start from 2 3 or some other points, then you just give that in this box and your X coordinates will start from that point. Now come to these options. Here it is 0 and right it is 10. That means we are getting 10 equal portions. If you count it, you will get 10 equal portions from your grid. And you can change the spacing between two points. That is a constant length. Each spacing are same. This spacing is very important. If you want to get your exact point, you have to set your spacing calculating as your requirement. I will show it after some minutes. Now just keep it as 1 meter spacing and the number of portion is 10 here. If you are satisfied with these settings, then you click on OK. To apply it on your workspace, just go here and click on this checkbox and it will not be any more default grid. It will be your personal my grid linear. Now our grid is ready and we will specify our points or nodes, then we will join them. Finally, we'll get our beams. For the first one, cantilever simply supported beam, the length is 10 meter. So first I have to give the first in point, which is 0 point. We can use this point as our first in point. I'm clicking here and a node has been created. As its length is 10 meter and each spacing is 1 meter, so if I click on this point 10, then I will get the complete length and I will get the beam. We're not specifying points, we're drawing our beams as well. A line is being created. So if I click here, then we are done and we have gotten our beam, but still we are in snap node or beam option. If you want to get out of this command, then you have to press escape. I'm pressing escape. Now you are out of the command. And if you want to draw again another beam, then you have to come here and this option is now disabled. So if I enable it here, then again I got a cursor to specify point. So you can press escape or you can click on this option to disable or enable it. We have drawn our beam so easily, but we don't need these grids anymore. We just only need our beam. To remove this grid, you have to come here, you have to click on this option, then there will be no grids anymore. For the second one, continuous beam, it has two length. First one is 10.25 meter and another one is 10.45 meter. So it is pretty difficult to get the fractional portion of the length. You have to change the spacing as 0.05, then you will get the fractional portion. To get that, you have to set the first point at 0 and the end point will be the total length of this beam. And it is 10.25 plus 10.45, which is 20.7 meter. Now I have to calculate what will be the total number of portion in the right direction. Then we have to divide 20.7 by 0.05, which is 4/4. But in snap node beam method, we cannot get that much portion. If we edit this grid, first we have to delete this beam. To delete, we have to select this beam, and to select we have to use beam cursor. cursor. I'm clicking here, then our cursor is now beam cursor, and now easily we can select a beam. Then we press delete button from our keyboard, and then we OK, and then we OK. Then our beam has been deleted. Then come to our grid option. We have to edit this, so I am clicking on edit option. But first of all, I have to activate it, then edit. Then if I give the spacing as 0.05 and the right point as 4:4, then I press enter. Then again I go to edit option, then I see there is 99, so it is pretty much impossible to snap our points by snap node or beam method. So one thing you have to keep in mind for linear grid method of snap node or beam, that is our length should be uniform. Anyway, I will draw this second continuous beam in the next video with the help of coordinate method. Now I am making it as earlier, it is 10 and the spacing is on. For the third one, it is pretty much easier because the fractional portion is 0.5, that is uniform, and we can snap it very easily. Here total length is 7 plus 3.5 plus 5, which is 15.5, and y direction it is 3.5 plus 3.5, which is 7 meter. So in x direction we have to divide 15.5 by 0.5, which is 31, and y direction we have to divide 7 by 0.5, which is 14. So again I go to edit option and I make it 31, and spacing I give here 0.5, and y direction I give it 14, and the same spacing I give it 0.5, and it is valid. So I click OK. Let's change the view. Now it is isometric view. I don't like this, so I'm going to this option, which is view from Z. Now I have to snap the point first, but now I don't have that cursor, so I have to go this option. If I enable this option, I will get a cross cursor. First length is 3.5 meters, so I'm clicking here as a first point and click on this point as a second point, so I get on column. Again we have to snap 3.5 meters, so I'm going up and click on this point, and we got another beam. Now right side it is 7 meters, so I can click on this point directly, but I don't want to continue drawing beam like this. I want to just draw the node, so I will press and hold the control key, then I will click on this point. Then see, this point has been drawn only, not any kind of beam, and now the beam is drawing from that point. I'm clicking on this point, I got that 7 meter beam. Again I have to go 3.5 from here, so I have to click on this point, but the initial point is here, so I have to press and hold control key, then I will click on this point and click here, then I will get that beam also. Similarly here it is 5 meters, so I'm clicking on this point, and finally I will click on this point, then I will get the column. Again I press and hold control key, then I click here and here, then I will get another beam. From this point there is a column, so I have to press and hold control key and click on this point, and down here again I press and hold control key and click on this point and click on this point. I have drawn all kind of beams or columns for the third one. Now I have to come out from this command, so I press escape, and if I want to remove these grids, then I have to uncheck this box, then I will get the total 2D frame. One thing I want to tell you, that all kind of beams starts from green. If I hold my cursor on this beam, then you can see this is highlighted, and as we selected first this point and the endpoint as this point, that's why that is blue and the first one is green. So from here we understand how we drew it. To observe the orientation of columns or beams, you have to right click, and there is a option label option. I'm clicking on it, and there is a option beam orientation. I'm checking on this box and apply, then OK. Then if we zoom it little bit, we see that the arrow is up, that's why it is drawn from bottom to top. For this column also it is bottom to top, but for this column it is top to bottom, which is wrong. So our orientation is not right for this column, for this one also, and for this one also. So again I am going to my grid, but before that I have to disable the orientation option. I am unchecking this beam orientation box, then apply, then OK. Then I am clicking on my grid option. Then I have to delete these columns first. So I have to activate the beam cursor. It is already activated. Here I can see that it is beam cursor. Then I select it and delete it. Again, I activate snap node or beam option. Then I will draw this column, but not from top. Now I will draw this from bottom to top. I press Ctrl and hold. Then I click on this point and this point. Again, press Ctrl and hold this point and to that point. Then I press escape and I uncheck this box. If I activate the orientation, then I can see that now the orientation is fine. For beam it doesn't matter, but for column it should be checked that your orientation is okay or not. If you don't want to show this orientation, then just hold shift and press O, then there will be not any orientation showing. Another one thing we can show on our drawing, that is dimension. To show dimension, you have to come here. There will be two options, display and remove. Now there is no dimensions, so I want to display it. I'm clicking on display, then close. Now we can see the dimensions of our beam. Anyway, I don't want to show dimensions here, so I'm going to dimensions again. Then I choose remove option, then I click remove option, then close. You can insert text if you want. For that you have to go here. There is an option, insert text option. I'm clicking here, and from here I want to start, so I'm clicking there and I give my text. I can change the font here, but I don't need this now, so I close OK and I got my text. Then I press escape to come out from the insert text command. If you want to select this text, then you have to come here. If you click on this command, then select your text, then you can move it anywhere you want. Then I press escape to come out from select text command. If you want to show node numbers, then you have to right click, then go to levels, then come to nodes. Here there is node numbers. That is unchecked. I am checking it and applying and OK. Then I am getting my node numbers. Similarly, we can number our beams also. For that I have to go to beams and here beam numbers, then apply. OK, you can do this from your keyboard also. For that you have to press and hold shift, then you will press N for node numbers. Those node numbers have been hidden. Again, if I press and hold shift, then press N, then the node numbers will be shown. Similarly for beam, I'm pressing shift and hold, then press B for beams, then my beam numbers are vanished. To show, I have to press and hold shift and then press B for beams, then I will get the beam number. This is how we draw beams in STAAD.Pro by snap node or beam method. This is all for today. You keep practicing. If you find any kind of problems or trouble, then comment below, or you can use the email address that I have given to the description. Till then, happy learning. See you in the next video.